Do we have any other questions?
This tight hand.
Favorite character to voice over? Quentin?
That's a tough one. I like doing myself. It's easiest for me to get into. You can wake me up anytime. The voice is always perfect. Not only is it lovely, but it's perfect. Like this morning when I got my phone call to wake up. Hello? Mr. Flynn, this is your wake-up call. It's 76 degrees outside. Call me back when the temperature changes. I enjoyed them all, but I was thrilled to play Spider-Man in the Marvel Ultimate Alliance video game. Because I was a huge fan of Spider-Man growing up reading comics, so that was a real joy for me. And I think with the popularity of Reno and Axel, it's, you know, my interest in it has grown because of your interest. So, those are both great fun. I like playing Reno because I get to be kind of sarcastic, a bit of a wise ass.
But Colleen O'Shaughnessy, everybody is fantastic, and the way the interaction between Quentin and Crispin is just fantastic. They're just completely at odds. They fight in their own ways with each other. It's great.
Nice adversarial relationship.
Yeah, you're gonna love it.
It's like a sibling rival.
Yeah, the brother you never wanted.
Exactly. kind of sense to me all the time.
I you know, Wolfwood for me also is my favorite. Because mostly, again, because you get to use your own voice for a change, and you're not like worried about the acting and you're not worried about pitching the voice and keeping that voice in the pocket. It's easy to keep your own voice in the pocket, and it's fun to act with a cigarette dangling at your mouth. Yes, cigarette.
No, we saw two hands now. Questions.
That's terrifying.
It brings up issues when I was a child.
Rick, where's the duck? Thanks to the duck for support. You do a lot of yelling on Luigi Mondays, where he's got attack cry, open mouth attack cry,
yaks constantly.
That's what it looks like in the script.
Yeah, and that's not mentioning like jumping off cliffs. Yeah.
No!
Switches it off. When I'm on the other side of the microphone, I don't hear what he and the engineer are saying. What
we're talking about is hair, mostly.
What I imagine is, hey, Quentin, hold on one moment. This is horrible. Fire this guy. Jeff, you did. I did? I'm a genius. All right, Quentin, one more take. Fantastic.
With the screaming especially, so we'll get to more questions. With the screaming especially, the level has to be just right, and sometimes you feel terrible asking the actor, who just did like an 8-second scream, I'm sorry, one more, you blew us out, blew out the microphone. And sometimes like they're screaming so loud they can't hear me going, stop, stop, save it, stop, stop screaming!
The look on my face, I'm sure, is always accommodating.
Yeah, it's like,
got it memorized.
There goes Rico. This happens. They ask him to say got it memorized and they squeal. But how many, do you get tired? you say about it when I saw when they drew a cartoonism on our MySpace page. Now it's like, it's just over and over again. Finally, I like, you know, pull out a hammer. Do you feel like you know, just a puppet sometimes?
Yeah.
I'll
put your
puppet
on the
ventriloquist.
Yeah.
Say, Axel, did you memorize that portion yesterday? Unbelievable. Yes.
Does it bug points in when people complain about why it is, and would you do white voice responding to all the hate you get?
I'm sorry, I couldn't hear you. The phone was ringing. Tom, I'll call it back.
The people who what?
Like if you could respond to all the people that complain about why it is in his voice, like what would you say?
Well, that was someone's got to go to the bathroom. Yeah, but you know what? It's okay. There's a bucket in the corner. I was talking to the one of the gentlemen who...
You're distracting something really funny happening that you just...
What's happening right now?
Voice acting? I've been in the booth as a director many times when some funny things have been said, but I'm not sure I can repeat it here. It's pretty dirty. Steve Bloom and Crispin Freeman are the dirtiest dumpers of all time. You're filthy on a whole other level.
I was gonna say, I figured I had the beat.
you improvise it. You're filthy in song. Start improvising during the song.
That's true.
Well, anyway.
We'll do that.
But as far as voice acting goes, I don't know.
Funny moments. There's been tons of funny moments.
Yeah, there's outtakes every single session. There's so many things. Well, recently, and I keep laughing at them all the time, there's a scene where, you know, Marcus has this itchy egg. I can't stop laughing. It's not even that funny, but it just strikes me funny. He's got this egg. I'm going to do this because I need to show the visual in my head. And his sister, Christy, played by Melissa Fawn, fantastic, by the way. She's standing there, and he has this egg. And he's supposed to just go, "Here, Christy, this is your Digimon," something like that. And instead he went, "I'm sorry, I've been drinking. Happy yesterday."